the given problem, we are required to find out the angle of tilt in member DC. We are given with the area of wire as 16 millimeters square, modulus of elasticity of the wire as 193 gigapascals. For finding out the angle of tilt, we need to find out the change in length of these wires due to this load, which will be by stress and strain relationships. So for that, we need to find out the force in each wire, and then find stress, and then find strain. From strain, we will find the change in length, and from change in length, we will find out the angle of tilt. First of all, we isolate this member and find out the forces in each wire. Force is 2.5 kilonewtons. Dimensions are in meters. Applying the summation of moments about point A. Minus 2.5 into 0.9. Since 2.5 is rotating in clockwise direction, so it is negative. Plus 0.9 plus 0.3 into FBG is equals to 0. The force in this member is FBG. So FBG comes out to be 1.875 kilonewtons. Now we apply the summation of forces in y direction. We get FAH plus FAH is the force in this member, and FBG is force in this member. Both are in positive direction. Minus 2.5 equals to 0. We knew that FBG is 1.875, so FAH comes out to be 0.625 kilonewtons. Now we have the forces in these members. This 0.625 kilonewtons is in this wire, and this wire is transferring the point load on the member DC. The member DC would be like having a force transferred by this wire as 0.625 kilonewtons, and the wires are DE and CF, the free body diagram. Now applying the moment equation about point D, we get the distances are 0.3 and 0.9 meters respectively. 0.625 into 0.3, it is a negative because it's rotating in clockwise direction, plus FFC into 0.3 plus 0.9, that is the lever arm from here to here, equals to 0. FFC comes out to be 0.1 5625 kilonewtons. Applying the summation of forces in y direction, we get the force in this wire is FDE plus FFC minus 0.625 is equals to 0. FFC is this value. FDE comes out to be 0.46875 kilonewtons. Now we know the forces in each wire. For angle of tilt, we simply have to find out the change in length in each of these wires. So we simply apply the equation as delta L is change in length is equals to force in the wire into the length of that wire upon area of that wire into modulus of elasticity of that wire. For wire ED, change in length of ED. ED wire is this one. This one wire is ED. For change in length of the wire ED, the force in ED is force in wire ED is 0.46875 kilonewtons is converted into newtons multiplied by the length of the wire, that is 0.9 meters over area of the wire is 16 millimeter square. We know that 1 meter square is equals to 10 raised power 6 millimeter square. So 16 x 10 to the power minus 6 meter square into 193 gigapascals. The change in length comes out to be in the wire ED as 1.366 exponent minus 4 meters. Similarly, for wire FC, change in length of FC is equals to the force in wire FC is 0.156 kilonewtons, 0.15625 in 10 power 3 newtons multiplied by the length of the wire FC. The length of the wire FC is same, 0.9 meters over area of the wire. Area of the wire is 16 exponent minus 6 meter square and modulus of elasticity is 193 exponent 9. Change in length of FC wire comes out to be 4.55 exponent minus 5 meters. Now, geometrically, we know that the wire FC is undergoing less change in length while FDE is undergoing more change. So, a free body after the application of load may be as 0.9 meters. In initial condition, it both wires were of 0.9 meters. While due to change in length, in DE the change in length was 1.366 exponent minus 4 meters, and change in this wire 4.55 exponent minus 5 meters. We need to find out this angle. Let's call this as angle alpha. This length would be 1.366 exponent minus 4 minus 4.55 exponent minus 5. That comes out to be 9.11 exponent minus 5 meters. So we will have a triangle like this, having this length as 9.11 exponent minus 5 meters. And the base of this length is 1.2 meters. This is angle alpha. Tangent of alpha is equals to perpendicular over base. The perpendicular is 9.11 exponent minus 5 and the base is 1.2 meters. Alpha is equals to tangent inverse 9.11 exponent minus 5 over 1.2. Angle alpha comes out to be 4.349 exponent minus 3 degrees, which is our required answer.